Shania Twain coming to town in May, and we've got front row tickets for you to win this morning coming up at 9:10. Utah Country 93.3 The Bull. It's Lexi M. Banks. What don't impress you much? That's the question we're asking right now.
What does impress us much?
What's the most impressive thing about you, Lexi, that if you were going to brag to somebody?
If I was going to try to impress you, I once cage fought a man in front of a crowd of several hundred people.
That's actually impressive.
I got my butt kicked. I did not win, but I did it.
801-570-9393. What's the most impressive thing about you? Give us some of the... So we posted this yesterday on Facebook.
Yeah, there's
and
some
got some pretty good responses.
Interesting stuff, Ash. Alyssa said that she bottle-fed a baby bear cub. That's pretty impressive, right?
Yeah.
Ashley said she has broken each collarbone 5 times. 2 times she had them broken at the same time.
What?
That sounds painful, but also slightly impressive.
I guess.
Absolutely. Sharon said she's been an extra in a zombie movie with a bunch of boy band singers.
Random.
So many questions.
Right.
And I want to know who the boy band singers
are. We're never
going
to get any answers out of that.
I feel like that one's pretty impressive. And then this lady says that she puppy sits for her family upstairs when needed.
Okay. So you're a dog sitter. That don't impress me. I mean, that's just what it takes to be a good neighbor,
sorry,
right?
That's not that impressive. Dog sitting is not that impressive.
What's the most impressive thing about you, all right? Call us right now.
801-570-9393.
801-570-9393. Tell us the coolest thing about you that might impress
us.
Yeah,
impress us.
If it's not impressive, though, that don't impress me much. Shania gonna let you know, okay? 801-570-9393. Front row seats to see Shania Twain coming up this morning at 9:10 on 93.3. Front row seats to Shania Twain on the way this morning at 9:10. You can win those. What's the most impressive thing about you? This is your chance to brag about you, okay? Call us right now.
801-570-9393.
It's Lexi and Banks on 93.3 The Bull. Marcy, what's the most impressive thing about you?
Doctors told me that I would not be able to have kids because I had cervical cancer stage 4. And a week later, after they told me I was scheduled to do a hysterectomy, and I found out I was pregnant with my daughter.
Miracle babies!
Congratulations!
Yeah.
That is impressive! You have impressed us.
That's legitimately impressive, Marcy. Congratulations. That's awesome.
Thank you.
All right. 93.3 The Bull. Hi, what is the most impressive thing about you?
I've been in 17 not-at-fault car collisions.
17 not-at-fault car collisions?
Yes.
I don't know. I mean,
I'm not exactly impressed about that.
So,
you're a bad driver.
No, I'm a good driver. Just all the bad drivers find me.
Okay, so you're a bad luck magnet. That don't impress me. Had to give it to you, Baloo. That's soft.
We still love you.
93.3 The Bull. Good morning. Hi. What's the most impressive thing about you?
Most impressive thing about me, I could probably... I play guitar both left-handed and right-handed, both electric guitar, bass, and acoustic guitar.
So, you're ambidextrous.
That don't impress me
much. I'm sorry, bro. That's not that impressive.
You mispronounced ambidextrous.
Oh, no! That don't impress me
much. It's not ambidextrous.
And that's all you need to know about me.
Thanks, brother. The Bull, hi. What's the most impressive thing about you?
I have been struck by lightning.
Oh, this is impressive.
That's like the ultimate bar story. You never have to buy a drink ever again.
Where were you, and are you permanently, is your hair permanently sticking out?
I was like 10 years old. I was in my backyard building a snowman with my father, and the lightning came down and it hit me in the side of the mouth.
And then were you lacked unconscious or anything?
No, honestly, I don't remember any pain. I just remember just scaring the heck out of me.
Wow, you got a story
like,
to tell.
You walked away from a lightning strike.
I mean, that's impressive.
That's very impressive.
You have impressed us much. Thank you so much.
The Bull, good morning. Hi. What's the most impressive thing about you?
So the most impressive thing about me is that I'm heading out Tuesday morning to Nashville for the CMA Awards that I won with you guys for
Poison
to St. Jude.
I saw you posting this online, too. You won them because you donated to the St. Jude Radiothon last year.
I did, yeah, and we're pretty excited. We're getting ready, and I just love you guys so much.
We love you more.
And we're impressed.
We don't get to go, so take lots of pictures and share them.
Yes,
with us, okay?
And will you call us next week when you're done with the... Call us the next morning and let us know everything that happened. We need to know everything.
I will. I'll call you guys Friday morning
okay.
next week.
I love it.
That sounds so good.
There
have the best
go.
Time.
Have a good day.
You too.
801-570-9393. What's the most impressive thing about you? It's Lexi and Banks on 93.3 The Bull. Utah Country, 93.3 The Bull. It's Lexi and Banks. Since the Powerball jackpot is now at $1.5 billion, how much money do you have?
Are you doing a runner for everybody?
It doesn't matter how much I got. Don't tell my wife.
Because that's a bunch of 20s in your hand.
It's an investment.
That's more than a little bit of money you got there, bud. So you're driving to Evanston for us on a Powerball run, right?
Yes.
Okay. I have for you an old Powerball ticket.
Oh.
And this won me $8 because I got one number right.
Okay, that's so you got to go cash that
so
in.
So technically,
for him.
I've already won the lottery, you guys.
$8.
Okay, there's $8 for you to go exchange.
So we're going
to
let it ride.
Yes, we're going to press, right? We're going to let it ride. And then here's 20 for me and 20 for Lex.
Oh.
All right.
So, I'll Venmo you $20.
Yeah,
then.
Venmo me the money later. When
my
we
ATM was closed.
When we win a billion, it won't matter,
It
Lexi.
Won't matter. That's right.
So what's the weather right now on the way to Evanston, Tiny? Do you have any idea what it looks like in the mountain passes?
It is cold, but I think the roads are clear, so we're good.
Okay. I think he's right. It doesn't really look like there's... I don't think you're really going to run into too many problems getting there.
Well, we're going to send you. Get us some tickets. Make us billionaires. That sounds awesome to say, doesn't it?
I would like to be a billionaire.
I could be an instant billionaire.
It would be really cool to be a billionaire.
I'm not even going to call in. You're just going to be like... How come we can't get hold of him on the phone anymore?
That's
it's
how we.
He's a billionaire now.
He's a billionaire now. He
That's
doesn't
what
need
happens.
Us.
You don't need to answer the phone when you're a billionaire.
All right, buckle up, drive safe. You're taking the company car, right?
Don't tell the boss.
Yeah, no, absolutely. We're burning the company gas on this.
And if we don't win, you're fired.
Just so you know. No pressure.
Yeah, I know.
I expect to win the lottery.
Maybe call us while you're up there. I need some fireworks too. Okay. We'll do that.
It's up by the liquor store.
We'll take care of that offline, though. We don't need to talk about that on
the Wyoming beer too.
I need some all of that. I don't care about that, but you know, Daddy could do for some M80s. I'd be all right with that. All right, Tiny, be safe. We're gonna check up with you on your Powerball run here in just a little bit, brother. Thank you.
Okay, see ya.
Utah Country 93.3 The Bull. It's Lexi and Banks. We've had a ton of fun with this all week, trying to find the biggest Shania Twain fans in Utah to go see her 5th, 4th, 3rd, 2nd, and today, first row tickets.
First row. It deserves
majestic.
A sing, Banks. It deserves a sing.
Incredibly operatic of you.
Thank you very much.
Call us
I
right now
that.
If you want to win these tickets. First row, Shania, May 24th at USANA Amphitheater. Our number?
801-570-9393.
Now, you've got to prove that you're a huge Shania fan by finishing the next line of this song. Listen up. That's it. That's all you're getting right there.
And you're going to have to sing it, by the way. If you talk it, we're going on to the next person.
Only giving you the one listen to it. 801-570-9393. Front row tickets now to see Shania Twain. Good luck. Ooh. Megan and Sandy, good morning. You're caller 13.
Woo!
Slow down. You haven't won anything yet, all right?
Something tells me she knows the next line.
You just got a chance at this. Front row seats to Shania Twain, May 24th. At USANA Amphitheater. Now, on a scale of 1 to 10, how big a Shania fan are you?
Huge.
11.
on a scale of 1 to 10, huge. Like, don't even answer the question. I hope you listen to this better than you listen to that question, okay?
11.
You got to prove it. We're going to play you a song. Tell us what Shania song it is and finish the next line correct, and you're going to win the front row seats, okay?
Hey.
Here we go. Listen up.
Moment on.
You got it.
Yay. That was good. And she sang it
front
terribly,
row.
But also awesome.
Shania.
Yeah,
you're
because,
going.
Guys, I just woke up and look, I'm singing for you.
Do you still have morning breath? Have you brushed your teeth yet?
No, I haven't. I just dropped the kids off at school. My breath is rank.
Okay.
We're
so
still
you've
wearing
got
our
morning
jammies.
Breath.
That don't impress me much. I'm impressed. I'm impressed.
I think it's pretty fitting, you guys, because that was the song I walked down the aisle to 20 years ago.
Really?
Really? No wonder you know it so well.
I know.
Well,
and you're
you got
still,
it.
And you're still married?
I'm assuming you're taking your husband.
No, I'm not taking him.
Why would I take my husband
20 years ago, Banks,
to hear her sing the song that walked us down the aisle? Heck no,
yeah,
girls'
that was
night.
20 years ago, he's no fun to take to concerts.
Who are you gonna take?
Probably my daughter.
Okay, that's nice.
That's an acceptable second place to your husband. All right. Have the best time. Front row seats. Shania Twain. You got it from 93.3 The Bull.
Thank you guys so much.
Utah Country 93.3 The Bull. It's Lexi and Banks. So the Powerball jackpot got up to $1.5 billion, right?
It's a lot,
Has it gone up higher than that now?
No, I think that's
it. It might.
I don't know. It doesn't matter. Does it matter?
So a couple weeks ago, I was excited when it was like $500 million. And I was like, ooh, man, that's a lot of money. I should buy a ticket. Now, like, the 0.5 is $500 million on that. Like, so don't be shy of the stuff to the right of the decimal point. It's still a lot of money.
Banks, I'm just hoping we win. If we win...
If we win, I'll spend $1 million buying tacos for the 93.3 The Bull family.
I think that's a great idea. $1 million in tacos.
I will spend up to $1 million in tacos just to say thank you to our friends
for
listening.
We will have to call ahead of time if we're going to get that many tacos, because I don't know if any restaurant could be prepared.
Tiny, the Powerball fairy, is on his way to Evanston to get us some tickets. How are you, brother? Where you at?
I am just about to cross over into Wyoming. I think the last sign I passed was 10 miles to Evanston.
Oh, you're getting so close. Oh,
so you're right by the train tracks. You've already turned and headed east. You're coming out of the canyon right now. I know right where you are.
Yeah, and it is freaking cold up here. I don't know how accurate this thermostat is on the truck, but it says 6 degrees.
Oh, no. Well, up in the mountains, it might be.
So, fun fact about me.
Yeah.
Part of my LDS missionary service was spent in Kemmer, Wyoming.
Oh, okay.
And so our area was Evanston, Kemmer, and Green River.
Right.
It would regularly get down to like 10 below.
Yes,
like,
yes.
Nobody would flinch out there. That's just like a normal winter day, Tiny. So,
well, when you win the Powerball, you can buy heat.
Here?
Because they have Powerball, dude.
Yeah, they've got Powerball. When you're a billionaire, you can buy all the heat. How many people are you buying stuff for today?
I think it's just you two and me.
Oh, so that other money was for you and
now,
your family. How many Powerball tickets?
I don't know what you're talking about, other money. No idea.
Okay. I have no idea about that other, like, $100 you had in your hand as you were leaving. Like, so...
Look, it's an investment if I win.
If you win.
$1.5 billion is where is at. Now, how many other Utah plates do you see around you right now?
Yeah, are you seeing other people doing runners?
There's actually, I'm kind of surprised at the amount of traffic that's up there. I'm wondering how many people are coming up here to come get tickets.
For $1.5 billion, all the people are. So, all right, well, let us know when you get the tickets, when you're on your way back, and be safe, dude, and stay warm. Did you bring anything other than the hoodie you had on?
Well, I did bring a couple jackets, but the truck heater's working spectacular.
Okay. 6 degrees in Wyoming right now, y'all. For a chance at the Powerball, I'll send you into the cold any day, Tiny.
Sure, I'll be glad to go.
All right, brother, thanks. We'll check up with you again in a little bit on our Powerball run, dude.
Thanks, see ya.
Utah Country, 93.3 The Bull. It's Lexi and Banks.
93.3 The Bull. Helping you decode your relationship red flags. It's Love Him or List Him with Lexi and Banks on The Bull.
Jesse, good morning. What is your relationship red flag today on Love Him or List Him? Cuz, what's up?
Hey, guys. He made his napkin into a bib.
Oh, like you put it in a shirt?
Like
one
cartoon
of those,
style?
One of those situations?
Yeah, kind of. We went to Pat's Barbecue, and he ordered ribs.
So good.
And when we were waiting for our food, he took his napkin and made it into a bib, like a baby would have.
Okay.
And, you know, it didn't even help. Like, I've never... He had sauce all over his face and hands. It still got on his shirt, and, like, there were a few drops on his pants. I mean, I just got a salad. I don't do barbecue.
Okay.
I thought it was so gross that he was covered in sauce. I mean, we've been out a few times, but this was our first time eating dinner.
Okay.
I had no idea he was such a messy eater. No adult should ever wear a bib.
I take umbrage with that, first of all, because I can think of several times where as an adult I would need to wear a bib.
I feel like I've seen you in a bib before.
Seafood boils. Like, there's lots of reasons to wear a bib.
Well, I mean, do you like him besides the bib?
I mean, I like him enough that I said yes 3 times to date. He's got, you know, a nice personality, but again, the bib?
All right.
The bib? Should I love him or list him?
There, you know, on the first date when you eat dinner with someone that you just met, there are a few rules, and one of them is don't eat spaghetti or ribs because you're going to look terrible.
It's like you could throw wings in there with that too.
Yeah.
Like there's no elegant way to work your way through that meal.
No, you look terrible. But I mean, he probably needed I don't know if this is a list-em situation. Some places you go to in the South, they actually give you a bib with your ribs.
I'm just saying he was prepared. He knew what he was getting into. He knew the sauce was going everywhere. That's why he put the bib on. You got a dude that was ready. He made a plan.
Sounds like he needed a full bodysuit, though, Banks. That even got on his pants.
Like he needed to go full Patrick Bateman with the rain suit.
She doesn't want to date a toddler.
I don't want to date a toddler. I mean, come on. And you want to make a good first impression. I carry dental floss wherever I go.
I would just like to also clarify that this was apparently a third impression, right, Jesse? Like, this wasn't your first time out.
No, but it was our first time eating out.
Yeah.
Got it.
Dinner date.
Whole new set of etiquette, you know?
It's true.
Call us right now. Does Jesse love him or list him for being a sloppy eater?
801-570-9393.
801-570-9393. You can wait for the results, right, Jesse?
Yes.
93.3 The Bull. Helping you decode your relationship red flags. It's Love Him or List Him with Lexi and Banks on The Bull.
This is Jesse's relationship red flag, in case you missed what she said.
He made his napkin into a bib.
So, love him or list him, what would you do with the bib guy? Call us right now.
801-570-9393.
Good morning. Hi.
Love him.
Because?
Well, I mean, a toddler doesn't care if the sauce gets all over their shirt and clothes, but at least he makes an effort to stay clean.
Valid point.
I hate saucy foods like ribs, so I just don't eat them because I can't stand getting messy. But if I do get messy, I'll go ahead and tuck a napkin in my shirt. So this guy seems legit to me.
He's going to bib it up.
He's a keeper. 93.3, good morning. Hi, we love him or list him.
Oh, I think you got to list her. She said she doesn't like barbecue.
It's a kind of a requirement for some people,
I mean, come on. Who doesn't like barbecue? I don't do barbecue. I got a salad.
Without brisket is not a life worth living, okay?
Yeah. And ribs, I mean, come on. I smoke ribs almost every weekend, it seems like.
I'm so proud
to
know
you. Do you get it all over your face and your pants and your hands and stuff?
Heck yeah.
Yeah.
Part of the experience. Happens. Thanks, brother. 93.3, hi. Love him or list him.
You said list yourself.
Yeah.
She should be on one of those All I Need to Know About You. I think she's going to be alone for a long, long time if that picky.
Just alone with her salad while those of us that love barbecue are together constantly being happy and fat. 93.3 The Bull, it's Lexi and Banks. Hi, love him or list him.
Well, we got two things here going against this lady.
Okay.
First, homeboy was trying to watch out for himself, keep himself clean. He already knows it's not going to work out good.
Yeah.
Eating barbecue. And if she doesn't like barbecue, she gone. List her.
She gone.
This is guy number two that said that.
She gone. Thanks, brother. Hi, it's Lexi and Banks. Last one here. Love him or list him?
I think she should love him.
Yeah?
I've been married 25 years, and if I just looked at all the little piddly things that my husband did, then our marriage would be terrible. But if I look at the good things and overlook those bad things, I think that it's great.
The good stuff outweighs the barbecue messy face bib and the barbecue sauce on the pants.
Don't sweat the small stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, don't sweat the small stuff. You're not going to make it in life if you always look at negative things.
And maybe invest in some bleach in one of those pens that gets the stains out.
The Tide pens.
The Tide pens, yeah.
Stain sticks.
I mean, that'll fix everything.
Thanks so much.
You bet. Bye.
Bye.
It's Lexi and Banks, 93.3 The Bull. Jesse, we're back. Are you ready for the results today with Love Him or List Him? Do you want to know what everybody said?
I do.
80% of the people who called in and we polled said that you should love him. Eating barbecue's messy business. And he took precautions. Eventually, someday, you're going to be eating gross stuff in front of each other if the relationship continues. And you are going to have to accept sauce on the face at some point.
I don't know if that's the answer I wanted.
One day, you two will be out somewhere. You'll stare at each other lovingly in the eyes. He'll reach down slowly, undo his belt, and you'll smile knowing what's coming as you follow suit. And relax the waistband on your pants, because he just ordered another round of a dozen 25-cent wings, and you all are about to go all in on the most romantic evening you could possibly think of.
Oh, no. Oh, my God. You really painted a picture
that
there, babe.
Sounds like happiness to me.
You got a little out of control. Okay.
Good luck, Jessie.
Right there.
I don't think it's going to take.
I think she's going to list
me. I don't think it's
going to take. What's going to go on? I've been listed now.
I'm listing you. You are no longer my co-host. I list you.
Jessie, thank you for being a good sport and for playing along with us and having some fun today.
Oh, no, it was great. Thanks, guys.
93.3 The Bull. It's Lexi and Banks. He took our money. Let's see if he took the money and ran or if he's actually got our tickets here.
He's going to be $20 richer.
93.3 The Bull. It's Lexi and Banks. $20 won't get you far. It'll cost him more in gas to get to Evanston and back than it will the $20 I gave him for Powerball tickets.
Right?
Tiny, the Powerball fairy is out. Do you have our tickets, brother?
I have got the tickets, and I'm heading to the barn.
Okay, to the barn. You mean you're driving back to the radio station, heading to the barn?
Yeah, we're going to barn.
Yeah, that's it. Head to the barn.
Like, the station's in South Salt Lake. We're not even, like, out in the sticks
not
anywhere.
Not very barny, yeah.
We're under the freeway at I-80.
Apparently, there used to be train tracks here.
So, are you secure in the location of the tickets? Are they in a safe spot? You're not going to, like, spill a Mountain Dew or anything on them this morning and ruin our chances at $1.5 billion?
No. They are safely protected. I've got them right here next to me. You know, tucked them away in a little high-quality convenience store plastic bag.
Okay.
You know, they're protected.
We are expecting you to guard them with your life, so if someone comes after them, you better give up your life for those lottery tickets.
Sacrifice everything to make me rich.
Well, I was thinking about it. That I got enough tickets that if I break down out here and it's in the middle of this tundra and how cold it is, I've got to make a decision. Do I want to, you know, wait and see if I get rescued or burn the lottery tickets to stay warm?
No, wait.
Oh, yeah.
No, I expect you to risk hypothermia.
I'd much rather have a tiny sickle than losing the lottery.
I mean, if you lose a fingertip or something for the sake of me having
$1 billion. Yeah, you'll be fine. You've got 9 other fingers.
It's a sacrifice I'm willing to make.
Gotcha.
7 other fingers and 2 thumbs.
they make legs.
Okay, so you got all the tickets. We're ready to go. The drawing's tomorrow night, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And I saw the video. He sent some video, which I put on the Lexi and Banks Instagram and Facebook pages. And one of them said, you're a winner. Was that Banks' winning $8 ticket? That was
Banks' $8 winner.
They make it sound like you're a real big winner, Banks. You can watch that also. I'll put that on the Lexi and Banks social media pages.
We are 36 hours away from me being a billionaire.
maybe me.
$1.5
Or maybe me.
$1 billion. Guys, don't even bother. I've already got the winning ticket in line, okay?
Let's make bets.
It's all right. I'll bet you a taco. Because right now, that's all I can afford. I win that Billy, I'll get you whatever you want, all right? Tiny, thanks for doing the Powerball run. If you haven't heard the news, it's $1.5 billion on the jackpot. It's almost $800 million if you take the cash option, which I totally would do, all right? Tiny, be safe, brother.
Hey, see you in a bit.
93.3 The Bull. It's Lexi and Banks.
Well, it's Lexi's.
Lexi's.
College.
Lexi's College.
Of Hollywood.
Hollywood.
Knowledge.
Hollywood knowledge.
Mallory, good morning. You're caller 13 on 93.3 The Bull. It's Lexi and Banks. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Awesome. Time to play Lexi's College of Hollywood Knowledge. There's 5 pop culture questions. You got to get more right than Lexi does, and you could win
my $100. Now, Mallory, did you get the two answers, the first two answers last night, $450, with the cheat sheet so you can beat me?
I haven't listened, no.
Okay.
Oh, Mallory.
Okay, good.
I could tell by the awkward pause that you were trying to figure out how to say it without getting yelled
that's
at.
That's awesome for me.
It's all right. Lexi, get out of the room. Right. Mallory, I still believe in you, okay? Good vibes on a Friday. Let's see if it's enough for $100 of Lexi's money. Remember, tie goes to Lexi. Since it's her money, we let her keep it. Are you ready?
Yes.
Matthew McConaughey is 53 today. What famous line did he deliver in his first ever movie appearance in Dazed and Confused?
All right.
Question number 2. Movie fans have been asked to stop leaving socks on a beach in Wales where Dobby the house elf was buried in what magical movies?
I have no idea.
Question number three. Ryan Reynolds will get the People's Icon Award at this year's People's Choice Awards. Ryan was Green Lantern and also what other superhero?
Deadpool.
Question number four. The Washington Commanders are for sale, and Jeff Bezos and Jay-Z are both two high-profile potential buyers. What professional sport do the Washington Commanders play?
Football.
Question number five. Lindsay Lohan has officially released Jingle Bell Rock nearly 20 years after she was in what movie where she sang and danced the Bobby Helms Christmas classic? What movie was it?
I'm trying to think of that.
I'm not like other movies.
I don't remember the name of it. I have no idea.
Let's wave Lexi back in.
Okay, so how'd she do?
Let me hang one, two, three out of five. Is
okay,
the
so
mark.
She got the average. You got the average.
Pretty good there, Mallory. Thank you so much. Let's get Lexi's answers and the score starting now. Question number one. Matthew McConaughey is 53 today. What famous line did he deliver in his first ever movie appearance in Dazed and Confused?
All right.
All right. I mean, can you imagine?
Or I keep getting older and they keep staying the same age.
The first words he ever uttered on film.
All right.
Question number two. Movie fans have been asked to stop leaving socks on a beach in Wales where Dobby the house elf was buried in what magical movies?
Dobby the house elf, magical movies. I do not know the answer. I'm going to have to guess magical Harry Potter's.
Correct.
Okay.
the beach where it was filmed in Wales, it's littered with socks now from fans just leaving stuff for Dobby the house elf.
Oh, they're so weird.
That makes it 2-1. Question number three. Ryan Reynolds will get the People's Icon Award at this year's People's Choice Awards. Ryan was Green Lantern and what other superhero?
I didn't know he was Green Lantern. Deadpool. I've actually seen that one because it was naughty.
3-2. Question number four. The Washington Commanders are for sale, and Jeff Bezos and Jay-Z are two of the high-profile potential buyers. What professional sport do the Commanders play?
This is going to be, I guess, the basketballs?
Football. They were the former Redskins.
Oh,
changed their name.
That's what now the Commanders. I understand. I've never heard of the Commanders before.
That makes
it. Sound more football-y now that I'm thinking about
it. 3-3 is the score. Question number five. Lindsay Lohan has officially released Jingle Bell Rock nearly 20 years after she was in what movie? Singing and dancing to the Bobby Helms Christmas classic.
They did it in Mean Girls, and they were all sexy, like way too sexy for
She's
high school
cool
girls.
All right, that makes the final score 4-3. It wasn't perfect, but it was enough today, Mallory.
Well, yeah, not getting my $100, but you are getting a pair of tickets from Vivint Arena to Trans-Siberian Orchestra November 22nd.
My name is Mallory, and I just want, out of Lexi's college, Hollywood knowledge.
I mean, the cheat sheet could have helped, would have helped, should have helped. Listen up this afternoon at 4:50 and get the first two answers, okay?
Okay.
We'll do it again Monday morning, 7:40 on 93.3 The Bull.
Pour some stupid on me.
Ooh, in the name of dumb.
Pour some stupid on me.
Come on, fire it up.
Let's talk about stupid people doing stupid things. This is Stupid Is.
Stupid Does.
My story comes from your old home, Lexi, Fort Myers Beach.
Oh, no. It's devastated right now.
A UFO was spotted flying around Fort Myers Beach.
Oh, no.
Some pictures were taken of it.
No idea how many times that happened when I lived there.
Really?
Yes.
You see UFOs
over
the beach?
I never saw them. My friends all claimed they saw them.
Well, this one actually has an explanation.
Okay.
Because on further investigation, a.k.a. one of the guys from the news station down there,
yeah,
actually saw it himself and took pictures, wasn't a UFO at all.
What was it?
Somehow, somebody's camping tent had been picked up.
I saw this.
Carried by the wind.
Uh-huh.
And was floating upside down in the sky.
Like hundreds of feet up.
No one called the cops or the authorities. Everybody just went, eh. Florida, and carried on about their day.
Yes.
Nobody flinched. What do you mean? Like, there could have been somebody in there. What if, like, a child got swept away from their backyard camping trip, and now they're soaring hundreds of feet above the ocean in this tent? You should call somebody about that, right?
I'm pretty sure there was no one in it.
There was no one in it, thankfully.
Wouldn't make it that far.
They don't even know where the tent landed. The wind carried it that far. But for, like, seeing the UFO, for your UFO being a camp tent, And then for nobody even reacting, nobody cared. Just another day in Florida. So the entire state is getting a stupid is.
Stupid does.
Like, call that in. Somebody call that in.
What do you want to bet that every other time people saw UFOs, it was the same thing?
Probably. Somebody's stuff blew away off the beach is right. All it was. Lexi, pour some stupid on me.
My story comes from Scranton, Pennsylvania, and it's about a 40-year-old man named Robert P. Redman Jr. And Robert is a truck driver, and he delivers Krispy Kreme donuts.
Delicious.
On November 1st, he stole his own delivery truck and nearly $800 in Krispy Kreme donuts. It's happened on Friday. Police began investigating the reported theft of a Krispy Kreme delivery truck because Robert never made his delivery that day or the night before. He also stopped responding to employers after he didn't make the delivery. Police eventually found him, and as it turns out, it was him just taking the truck and not returning it and taking all $800 in donuts. The truck has since been returned. He was arrested. I don't know what has happened to the donuts, but we do have to give him a stupid is. Stupid does.
What a waste of donuts.
I mean, those trucks have GPSs in them.
It's not like you can black market sell those donuts for like a dollar out the back of the truck and make a big difference.
No,
you know?
I mean, you got to get them fresh. Also, That's your own delivery truck, bro.
You get them when the hot light's on so they melt when you eat them. You don't even have to chew.
Yes.
Get them old out of the back of somebody else's truck. Man,
chewing
that's ridiculous.
Is for suckers.
Okay. If you want to see the full stories and get more, see the Lexi and Banks Facebook page for the links.
That's all I need. That's all I need to know about you.
That's all I need.
That's all I need to know about you.
That's all I need.
That's all I need to know about you.
Call us with your snap judgments about life moments that make you think that's all I need to know about you.
801-570-9393. If you tell us that the road construction on I-15 northbound is going to be done by 5 a.m. and it's 5:20 and I'm driving to work and it's dead stopped because the road construction's still going on.
I drove through it too.
That's all I need to know about you.
The sign says expect delays up until 5 a.m. It was like 5:20 and I'm dead stopped.
Yes.
One lane. Northbound I-15 at 5300 South.
And I don't think I-15 has recovered since then.
I think it's going to be slow all morning. If you want to know why, it's because they were doing construction earlier. Okay. If the principal of your child's school has to come up to the window of your truck to clarify an altercation that you had in the parking lot with another parent in the pickup line, that's all they need to know about you/me.
Thanks. But that lady did deserve a tongue wagon.
Yes,
and
she did.
A
so
wagon.
The principal agreed with me. I was in the right. The other lady was being a beast for cutting in line. So sorry, not sorry about it.
And now Banks is the school pickup and drop off.
I'm the enforcer.
Enforcer, yeah.
I'm the muscle around here.
Don't mess with him.
Don't cut in line while I'm around. The Bull, good morning. Hi, go ahead.
All right, when you're tailgating me on the freeway, get around me, get in front of me, and decide to slow down. That's all I need to know about you.
It's like they want to win the race, but then they want to stop racing once they get in front of you.
No, it's because they're driving like a normal human being, which is okay. Like, if you're the slower traffic, get right. But then they'll get past you, and then they get on their phone, and that's what makes them slow down.
That truth.
Hang up and drive. Otherwise, that's all I need to know about you.
Exactly.
Yeah, if you fart and blame it on someone else, when it's very clear that it was you, that's all I need to know about you.
It's the perks of having dogs or kids is it's never my fault anymore.
Are you the farter or the fartee?
Get out of. No, I wasn't the farter. I was in an elevator.
She was the fartee.
Oh, no.
In an elevator.
Okay, well, if you are driving down the road after dark on Halloween without your headlights on, that's all I need to know about you.
Yeah.
I mean, you could really just take the on Halloween thing out and add that to any day, but especially Halloween because, you know, the kiddos are out everywhere.
I saw someone without their lights on this morning getting on the highway.
It's like foggy and snowy.
Right?
Turn your lights on.
If there's an emergency vehicle driving down the road and you stay in the fast lane and don't move over, and then the ambulance has to go around you, that's all I need to know about you.
Oh, and the ambulance went around, I mean.
Like the basics of driving, like you always get over to the right.
And stop, yes.
Can I add that too, by the way? Like, if everybody gets over to the right and then the ambulance goes by and you're trying to be that one cheeky guy at the back of the line to follow the ambulance up and pass everybody, that's also all I need to know about you.
You know.
Get back in line where you pulled over. Okay, call us if you got a snap judgment about a life moment that makes you think that's all I need to know about you.
801-570-9393.
It's Lexi and Banks on 93.3 The Bull.
This Lexi and Banks podcast is brought to you by The Advocates. Injured in an accident? Call The Advocates. 801-355-5550.